Last week, a mysterious Twitter post by the official Assetto Corsa account hit us out of nowhere. It included a screenshot of the new 2019 version of the Aston Martin Vantage. Six new cars and one new track were also announced in the very same post as a free update, which was set to release soon. From this day on, day after day after day, pictures of these six cars and the new track were posted, until Wednesday, where the last new car was presented. Therefore, version 1.1.1 of Assetto Corsa Competizione is out now. And the best thing, it is completely free. So what exactly was added in this update, apart from the obvious 6 new cars and the new track? Are there any new features? Are triple screens finally supported? Which one of the new cars is the most competitive? We are going to go over all of these topics in this video. Except the last one. But I will most definitely do a whole video about the performances of the new cars. Nevertheless, let's dive right into the new content. Starting off, there are the 6 new cars, which are the Audi R8 LMS Evo, the Lamborghini Huracan GT3 Evo, the Honda NSX GT3 Evo, the Aston Martin AMR V8 Vantage GT3, the Porsche 911 GT3 R2, and the McLaren 720S. Basically, all of those cars are more or less the same as their old counterparts, but with the BOP from the 2019 season applied to them. Oh yeah, and the Aston Martin now has lost its V12 engine, which is quite sad, but it now features an 8-cylinder version, which makes the car more competitive. Additionally to the 6 new cars, a new track has also been added, namely the future F1 circuit in 2020 in the Netherlands. Yes, I'm talking about the one where overtaking is rather difficult. The Zandvoort GP circuit. Nevertheless, I'm excited to finally be able to race on this track in ACC, since I really like its layout and its corners all have a natural flow to them, if driven right, of course. Now, not exactly new, but still changed, or rather updated, were a few tracks that were already present in the game. Since the real tracks in Barcelona, Silverstone, Paul Ricard and Spa were at least slightly resurfaced in some places, the new surfaces are now also available in the game, visually as well as in terms of the physics. So Kuno states the following. The lap times should be slightly slower in Barcelona, around 2 seconds slower in Silverstone, and about 1 second faster in Paul Ricard. Spa, on the other hand, has a rather interesting message, which says small difference. So they didn't specify whether the surface is now more or less grippy than before, but time will most definitely tell what's the case. This covers pretty much all of the new content. So let's move on to the gameplay changes. To be honest, I could go over every single one of them, but since most of them are quote-unquote just bug fixes and nothing really new, it would just stretch the video unnecessarily. If you are interested in what has been fixed, I will put a link to all of the changes in the description. Though there is one thing that really caught my attention, since it is a small but very welcome addition, or rather adaption. If you've ever played one of the F1 games and did some races against the AI, you for sure saw the Williams team finish a race in the top 10, for example, which is totally unrealistic and removes a little bit of the immersion. Well, in ACC, this shouldn't happen, because Kuno's adapted the driving skills of every single CPU driver, and they should now finish in front of drivers who are slower than them in real life, and obviously also behind those which are faster than them. However, one of the biggest and most important changes of version 1.1.1 was made to the user interface, or rather the graphics in general. Under one of my last videos, someone said how much they love ACC, but also how sad it is that a triple screen setup is not natively supported since the Unreal Engine really isn't made for multi-monitor setups. But apparently, Konos hired some wizards which applied a little bit of their magic capabilities on the Unreal Engine and managed to create a workaround for said problem. In other words, ACC is now fully compatible with triple screens, and to be able to use them, you can simply enable them in the graphics settings. Now, if any one of you watching this video plays ACC on a triple screen setup, I would really appreciate it if you could tell me how good the workaround actually is and whether you experienced some problems or not. Feel free to leave me a comment if you want to share your experiences. Oh yeah, and Konos also mentioned that it could come to some problems or bugs in the user interface, and in order to prevent them, you can delete your menu-settings.json file. This file can be found under this location. Now, on to the last two changes, where one is more or less just for visual pleasure and satisfaction, so to say, and the other one has a drastic influence on the general behavior of all cars. Starting off with the first option. Do you remember the days when you needed to pit, approached your pit box, and no one was waiting for you? Maybe your crew didn't like you. Maybe they were afraid of you. Were they also making fun of you while you floated in the air and your tires magically changed? You never really knew. But these days are now over. What I'm trying to say is that your pit crew always liked you and no one ever made fun of you. With the release of version 1.1.1 of ACC, your pit crew is finally bold enough to show up if you want them to. You just have to enable them in your general settings and they will show you all the love and support you really deserve. Now on to the next point, and I somehow feel like this has become a standard for every update in ACC, but there have again been some changes regarding the overall physics of the game. Firstly, there is now a whole new aerodynamic slipstream simulation model. Sounds complicated? Is probably complicated to simulate, but in a nutshell, the outwash of a leading car now affects a following car as well as the leading car. The leading car will experience slightly reduced downforce and therefore also less drag, while the following car has less air available to produce downforce, so it experiences more loss of downforce and drag than the car in front. These calculations are obviously also affected by the angle of your rear wing and your diffuser. So be careful now when following another car, especially in high-speed corners, since you might run out of downforce now. From my own testing, I can say that especially the loss of downforce when following someone in a turn is much higher than before and has already caught me off guard once or twice. Lastly, they also changed the tire degradation to a model that resembles the 2019 tires much more closely. So some tracks may feel more grippy now, but your tires are also degrading faster. There have also been some tweaks in the terms of force feedback. It is now a little more detailed when you're driving over a curb or are partly in a sand trap. So that was it for this video. If you happen to enjoy it and maybe get something useful out of it, you can consider subscribing to this channel for more sim racing content. And with that said, I will catch you in the next one. Cheers!